This decisional balance sheet is really quite effective at helping us to find the reasons why change is actually important for us. And it's all about change. So what you do is you fill all parts of this out. You write down all the disadvantages you can think of not changing, you know, of not changing whatever behavior or not taking action towards a particular goal. Then you write all the advantages of not changing. What are all the advantages of staying in the status quo? Then we write the disadvantages of changing. We've got to recognize that there are some disadvantages if we're going to change our behaviors or try to achieve goals that maybe we thought were not achievable. And the last thing we do is we write the advantages of change. And this is essentially, you know, what you want your life to be like. So this is an actual example of a client of mine, and it was all about improving their health and fitness. So it doesn't have to be massively specific. It can be generic or more general, or it can be very, very specific. So in this, for instance, disadvantages of not changing, cost of health, the economic cost, as well as the health deteriorating. This person playing with kids was important. It was an older parent. Burden on the family later in life, that feeling of isolation, of being overweight and unfit, the low confidence and self-esteem that comes with it. Then the advantages, you got to recognize the advantages of status quo, because it is hard. You know, there is probably going to be a cost in terms of time. You got to recognize why you do certain things. In this case, it was food and alcohol for de-stressing. And the other one is just, hey, it's more natural just to be like I am currently being. Then we recognize the disadvantages of change, which could be particularly around exercise. I don't like it, makes me uncomfortable. Lots of effort is required, whatever the change may be. There's a time cost. And often things like, I'll only feel again. I've been there, I've felt before, and I don't want to feel again. And then the advantages could be things like improved confidence and self-esteem, feeling better, more energy for work and life, better mood, easier to play with the kids, these sorts of things. And the list can be quite long, and it's worthwhile spending a fair amount of time actually going through this, because this is the kind of reminder of your motivation. This is, in Anthony Robbins' words, find your why, you find your way, or Friedrich Nietzsche, he who has a why to live for can bear almost any how. So guys, when we've done this, this is kind of how you analyze this from a coach's perspective. So this is kind of what I'd look at it. Up here is often what we call the concrete boots of habit. And if we flick back here, you know, there's kind of a habit in terms of food and alcohol helping to de-stress and those sorts of things. And what we find down here in the bottom left, often, not always, but often contains fears and apprehensions, and often these can be automatic negative thoughts. Like a classic automatic negative thought is one that I will only feel again, and particularly if this person has failed before. But the key thing to do is to what we call develop discrepancy. So think about how different life would be if you don't change compared to if you do change, and it's really think in the future. A, I haven't changed. Up here in the top left is what's going to happen. How different is that to if I do change and life will be like the bottom right? So this can be very, very useful looking at this. When we struggle with motivation or when we just need reaffirming as to why we're doing it, this can really, really help. And it can also help people who are kind of a little bit ambivalent. Should I change? Should I not change? This can help provide a lot of really good clarity as to why they should change.